Griff Hanlon. Welcome and thanks for joining me today. Today I want to talk about a tune, Hoochie Koochie Man, Old Muddy Waters classic. But the reason that I want to talk a little bit about it is A, it's a very classic riff and a very classic idea, and I want to talk to you a little bit about where it comes from. But also, having heard this song done in many ways by many different artists over the years, this is a great example of how a certain riff, even by the same artist, gets modified over time or can be played in many different ways. And I like to share this because I like you to see that many times, in fact, most times, there's not just one right way to play a song. And so what you hear and what works for you may not be exactly the same as the next guy, but that doesn't make it wrong. And it doesn't make anything else more right or more wrong. So let me quick give you kind of a rundown. One of the oldest Muddy Waters recordings I could find of this, the notes were B flat, C, D, and G. And he actually, in the video that I saw, had a capo at the first fret. And so he actually played the B flat open. With the capo at the first fret, the B flat would be the first fret on the fifth string. I tend to play it using my pinky on the sixth fret of the sixth string. The song being in G, it's all pentatonic scale, right? So if we look at good old box one there, all of the notes are right there. B flat, C, D, B flat, G. And in one of the oldest recordings, that's all it was. It was that over and over. Gypsy woman told my mother, before I was born, got a boy child's coming, gonna be a son of a gun, and so on and so forth. Just that over and over until, then you know I'm here. And then just kind of any kind of C idea. I like the, what I call blues in C. That same idea, right? So that's a fairly straightforward approach, and it'll work great. But it's far from the only approach, because later in Muddy's life, I saw him playing it in another video, and it went a little more like this. And he still did the B flat to the C to the D to the B flat, but he played this high G. And it was not capoed. And if I recall, he played B flat, C, open D, and then the B flat here. And I might be wrong about that. It might have been with down here. And he played the high G. And then from there on, he did D, F, D, F, G, which is another part of this. So you could alternate, and that's what I hear a lot. So that's another alternative that works very, very, very well. Then, if you hear something like a little bit more blues rock version, there's a great version by Jeff Healey. It goes a little bit like this. And so he's, instead of using the straight D to F to G, he's using D to a bar of F and B flat. And ending with sort of a power chord, the D and G. And it's pretty much that over and over. Now later on, you also had, like, there's an Eric Clapton video where he's playing it in A and basing around kind of an A power chord. So he's playing the C and the D and E, right? You could play it like that, but it's a little easier, because he ends with the open A string and the E and maybe a touch of the A. So we've gone from that all the time to that sometimes, to adding in that sometimes, to maybe this, to that, or with a power chord at the end. Clapton did that in A. So you can see there's a lot of variations when it comes to a tune like that. And it's not the only song where that's the case. There are a lot of old classic blues tunes where if you listen to one recording, you'll hear one idea or one riff. And then if you listen to another recording, you'll hear, while a similar riff, not quite the same, with definitely some variations. So I hope that in this video, I've shown you not only the fact that there's not necessarily one right way to play a blues song, because in many cases, there's many, many options. And also that if you're in a jam session, okay, and somebody says, hey, let's play Hoochie Koochie Man, now your ears are open for which version they might be playing, okay? Because this is a really common thing. You go to a jam, somebody says, hey, let's play Hoochie Koochie Man, and they start playing, and you're like, okay, I know that song. And all of a sudden, they do one of these variations, and you're like, well, wait a minute, that's not how I learned it, and now it's a big train wreck, because you're trying to play one thing, you're thinking you're right, and they're playing something else, thinking they're right. That doesn't work out. If you can be the flexible one, and if you can be the one with, as we say, big ears, who can hear, oh, they're doing that other variation, I know that variation, I'll join in and I'll play that. Okay, well now you've been exposed to at least a few different variations, as many as I've ever heard. So now that you've been exposed to those variations, if you have them in your bag of tricks, when it comes up on a jam session and somebody plays it a little bit differently than maybe you typically play it, but you recognize it as, oh, hey, I know that variation, all right, I can do that. That's going to make you an asset to any band or any jam session. So I hope you got something out of this. Hope you had some fun with it and maybe learned a new song today. All right, I'll talk to you soon.